So guys, welcome back to another video. Hope you all enjoyed the last one. If you haven't seen the Wellfest video, go and check it out now. This week is testing week. And for those of you who have been following the journey for the last couple of months will know that the last 8 to 12 weeks have been leading up to this point where I'm finally in a routine of training regularly. Nutrition is almost on point. Could be a lot better. And we've gotten to a place now where we're kind of relatively happy with where strength levels are at. Obviously, I know they're not kind of fantastic by any means, but look, we are where we are. And as long as we only compare ourselves to ourselves and where we've been, then we're happy. Okay, so this week we are testing a couple of things, hence why it's a full week rather than just a day. And the reason obviously I broke it up into the week is because I want to attack each one of these tests with almost 100% freshness. And because they're maximal strength tests, they're gonna take a lot out of, we'll say, my own nervous system in terms of actually being able to recruit muscles to complete the lifts. And you'll accumulate a lot of fatigue, and I obviously don't want the fatigue to carry on to the next test. So I've split them up into a couple of days and I've kind of set it up as best I can to go on Monday, Wednesday, Friday to kind of get the best out of myself and then get the kind of most reliable results from those tests as well. I've got my diary book here and I have all of my tests and kind of my attempts and the goals for those tests in them as well. So if you just have a look at that there, so again, so the top we've got our squat, bench, deadlift. Down here then we've got our jump test, so we've got a squat jump, a counter movement jump, and a broad jump. We have a rough estimate of where I want the body weight to be at for 82 kilos. Pull up, wide grip, at least 10 full ones, or if I can go 50% of my body weight added to one chin up, so that is a gross overestimate of what I'm able for now, but again, it might be no harm to try. And then a 20 meter sprint, I'm looking for a sub 3 seconds. Let me just take a minute or two less, hopefully, to kind of put that into context for where I am. I'm not a strength athlete, I'm a field sport athlete, so maximal strength isn't a high priority for me. These testing sessions are done periodically throughout the year, maybe once or twice a year, to help kind of inform a program prescription for what weights I should be using in any given phase. Because the last thing I want to do is to underestimate how much I should be lifting and kind of not give myself the best possible chance of progressing. I know that you can use obviously things like auto-regulation where you pick and choose what weight to use on any given day, but I'd rather not use that and I want to have as much data as I possibly can to give myself, again, as much chance as I can of progressing. And the second thing is, are these numbers kind of very relevant? The most relevant ones are obviously going to be the squat jumps, the counter movement jumps, and the broad jumps, as they are more representative of kind of where I want to be at. Obviously, as an athlete, you want to be able to jump and be quick. And while strength obviously has a massive part to play in that, you're having a high squat doesn't necessarily mean you're going to be a fast sprinter, because to be a fast sprinter, you have to be strong, but also you have to be technically efficient at running. And it's something that I'm going to start working on a little bit more. So again, that's going to play into it as well. The deadlift, I haven't deadlifted from the floor in probably about 4 months. So that's going to be interesting. I've incorporated heavy rack pulls and dumbbell RDLs, as you know. So it'll be interesting to see where I go with those. And pull-ups, I've done chin-ups mostly for the last three months. I haven't done very many wide grip pull-ups. I've done the occasional one where I'm in the gym messing about. So again, that's going to be an interesting one to see where I am. Testing day one, so the game yesterday. So taking today to just do bench, because it wouldn't be fair myself to do any lower body testing or sprints or jumps or any of that. So just bench today. Again, working up to at least an 80 kg bench. Let's see how that goes. Push, up. Hey! New PV. Yeah! Day one of testing done. Just benched today because obviously with the game, wouldn't make sense to test anything lower body. So tomorrow will be the jumps, sprints, and squats, so it's probably going to be the busiest day. And then day three then will be deadlifts from the floor for the first time in about 6 months. So good start, 90 kilo bench, 10 kilos more than what I thought I was going to get. It was a bit kind of a grinder, so whether I actually accept it or not as a true 1 minute max, we'll see. The 80 kilos was obviously a lot smoother and a lot faster, so you're looking at probably 85 kilos as we'll say like a proper one rep max where I can control it, keep my back flat on the bench because obviously I'm not a power lifter, but little things like that. So again, catch you guys in day two. Welcome to day two. Today we are looking at our jumps and squats. Jumps on the jump mat, and then squats. So again, looking at a probably like a 110 kilo squat, and haven't really figured out how high the jump's gonna be. But hopefully it's not a shitty number. Today I'm using a just jump mat, testing my jumps. I was gonna do squat jumps and counter movement jumps, but I think today I'm just gonna stick with the counter movement jumps. One, because time that I have, I won't get through all of it, and the counter movement jump is a little bit more specific to my end goals with this testing period, and obviously with my next training program and the training programs from. Just counter movement jumps, I'm gonna have 3 attempts. There's gonna be about a minute to a minute and a half break between each one, and I'm gonna take the best one from those tests. I've done a couple of warm-up jumps, so looking forward to see what I get. Transferring over to the G7X for this because the battery in the Canon M10 is gone. Jumps just finished, relatively happy with them. Like I said, I didn't know what numbers I was gonna get, so it gives me something to work off now. I remember the first time I used the jump mat in here, it was like 0.61 and 19 point something. I know the second number is measured in inches. I'm not sure what the first number is measured in, but look, we have a number now and it's something to work with and work towards improving. Moving on to squats now, so because I've already done the jumps as well, the warm-up should be a little bit quicker, so I'm going to start at 40, looking at doing sets of 3 to 5, move on to 60, again 3 to 5, then hit 80 for a set of 3, and then I'm pretty sure I'm just going to go to singles then, so I'll hit 100, and then anything after that then is a PB, so I'll go 100, I'll probably go 105, potentially go 110, and then see, may attempt 112.5, but we'll see how we feel. Proper attempt number 100 kilos. Bear in mind, I got this a couple of weeks ago on after doing 5 sets of 5 at about 90, or it was 90 at the time, so this should be relatively easy. Attempt number 2, 110, belted. I could count them if I want to. All these years I've wasted on you. You gave up. Okay, so that was attempt number 2. 110 kilos came up pretty well, and depth was acceptable from my point of view, so I'm gonna go and try 120 kilos. I'll have to have a spot for this one definitely, and as a famous man once said, if he dies, he dies. This is the face of a man who just got a 1.5 times body weight squat. Extremely happy with it given the problems I've had with my knee over the last year. The knee gave me a little bit of trouble there about 3 weeks ago. Couldn't walk on it. Like I could, but just excruciating pain. And again, it just shows the last 2-3 months of training has worked. So 1.5 times body weight squat. Looking forward to day 3 now, 2 times body weight deadlift, and then that'll be a clean sweep of targets for my testing week. Okay, welcome to day 3, third and final day of testing. Today was meant to be sprints and deadlifts, but I think today I'm just going to focus on the deadlifts. Not for any particular reason, but I think I might just leave the sprints for another day. Just again, focus down on the deadlifts, getting them to where I want them to be. So let's get on with it. First 3 warm-up sets down. 2 sets at 70 with the wide grip. 1 set at 110 with the conventional grip, mixed grip, 1 more set at 110, and then I'm gonna go to doubles at 130, and then I'm gonna start hitting singles, so it'll be 140, 150, and then hopefully 160. Okay, so that last attempt you saw there was 150. Again, all things considered, the fact that I haven't deadlifted off the floor in, I'd say roughly either before or just after Christmas, so you're looking at probably like 5 months. So again, in that 4 to 6 month time frame, 150, not bad. Again, I probably won't go any heavier, because if I do, then technique is going to start to slip massively. But like I said, all things considered, pretty happy so far this week. Almost a clean sweep of hitting all my targets, which I can be incredibly happy with. I now have numbers to work with when I'm planning my next training block, which will be done either over the weekend or into next week. So next week I'll just be playing around with new movements, new exercises, and then we should be good to go with a new program then the following week. So overall, happy with that. I'm going to leave it there for this video, because if I do any more, it's just going to be incredibly long. So hopefully it gives you a little bit of an insight into the testing procedures, the exercises that we use,